we are going to discuss about the two defect of vision, which are short-sightedness and the long-sightedness. There are two distances in the normal eye. The first point, which is called the near point. Near point means the least distance which can be seen by the normal eye. So the least distance which can be seen by the normal eye is 25 centimeter. This is the minimum distance, the least distance which can be seen by normal eye without any pain is 25 centimeter. This is also called the near point. So the near point of a normal eye is 25 centimeter. This means for a normal eye, if a book is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter from the normal eye, then the person can easily read the books without any pain. So near point of a normal eye is 25 centimeter. Now let's see the far point. The maximum distance or the farthest distance that can be seen by the normal eye is infinity. We can't measure the maximum distance. This means a person can see a very far distance clearly. Okay? So we can't measure the far distance, far point. So the far point is infinity. Okay? Now, so a normal eye has the near point is 25 centimeter, while the far point is infinity. And as you are seeing in this diagram, in both the cases, the rays of light in the eyeball, both the rays of light meet at the retina. So it is essential for an eye to see the object clearly that both the rays of light meet at the retina. Okay? So if, in other words, I can say that if both the rays of light do not meet at the retina, this means a person can't see the object easily, clearly. A person can't see the object clearly. So the near point of a person is 25 centimeter or the far point is infinity. Let's see the first defect of vision, which is called short-sightedness. In the short-sightedness, the defect occurs in far point. We know that the far point of a normal eye is infinity. But in this case, in the short-sightedness, the defect occurs in the far point. In this case, a person can't see the distant objects. So, the person who is suffering from the short-sightedness can't see the distant object. Can't see the board in the classroom. If such type of person is sitting at the back side of the class, in the last bench, so it is difficult for that person to see the board. Okay? So in the short-sightedness, the defect occurs in the far point, and the person who is suffering from the short-sightedness can't see the distant objects. Now let's see the correction of short-sightedness. A short-sightedness is corrected by using a concave lens of suitable focal length. Okay, so by using a concave lens, let's see in the second diagram, both the rays of the light meet at the retina. And as I have told you, when the rays of the light meet at the retina, then such type of the person can see the object clearly. In the first diagram, let's see the first diagram, this person is trying to see the distant object. But as you are seeing in this diagram, the rays of light in the eyeball meet before the retina. They do not meet at the retina, they meet before the retina. So due to which, this person can't see the distant objects. Short-sightedness is corrected by using a concave lens. Okay, and when the concave lens is used for the correction of short-sightedness, you see in the second diagram, both the rays of light meet at the retina. Now this person can see the distant object clearly. Now let's see the second defect, which is called the long-sightedness. In the long-sightedness, the defect occurs in the near point. Okay, the defect occurs in the near point. In this defect, a person can't see the nearby objects. A person can't see when the object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter from his eyes. When a book, for example, when a person is suffering from long sightedness and when a book is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter from his eyes, then he can't read the book because the defect occurs in the near point. Actually, his near point increases from 25 to 35 or from 25 to 40, due to which he can't read the books. Okay, let's see the first diagram. This person is suffering from the short-sightedness, and you know that when the object is placed and when the book or object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter, then the rays of the light, let's see the diagram one, the rays of the light do not meet at the retina, due to which the person can't see the object clearly. The person can't read the books. Okay, or the person can't see the alphabets clearly. Now this defect can be corrected by using a convex lens. Let's see the second diagram. This defect can be corrected by using a convex lens or suitable focal lens. Now this person used a convex lens. Okay, and due to which, when the object is placed, now when the object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter, let's see in the diagram, both the rays of light meet at the retina. Let's see the diagram number two. When the convex lens is used for the correction of long sightedness, and when the object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter, now let's see the diagram number two, both the rays of light meet at the retina. Now in this case, a person can see the object. A person can read the books when it is placed at a distance of 25 centimeter from his eye. This person can read the newspaper. Okay, thank you very much.